My agents are still in Ellis. We'll keep the diplomat here just for the sake of he's going to be shipped off anyway. But I don't like keeping the spy here for, you know, whatever reason. You know what? He has a 92% chance of getting inside this Athenian capital. And although Athenians are fellow Greeks, I don't really trust them, and they're a primary rival. So let's see if he can't sneak in there or not. He is successful, and we can take a look at the factionaires, but I won't dwell on this too much. This is just... They have quite the military force, though. If I ever do go to war with them, I'm going to really have to raise a large military to strike them down. But if there's one thing Spartans are great at doing, it's raising a large military. So with my agents out of the way and my settlements building and my military forces reassembling, I think I'll just end the turn. Alright, we're back on the next turn. Let's see, first things first. My ship has been built, which is fantastic. I don't see any pirates. So we're going to gamble my brave little, well, I don't know if he's brave yet, but my diplomat away. We're going to put him on the ship and send him right over to this little island community. Hopefully none of those bastard pirates will come by. All right, and just a basic end of turn report. As far as our financial situation goes, we're still making more and more money. I'm not finished recruiting just yet. I still have quite some expensive units coming through the system, so I'll hold off on recruiting until I see where I am financially after they've been recruited. In addition, I don't believe any buildings have been constructed, so we're fine there. One agent is on a ship. Well, this one is still chilling out in Athens. I'm going to just have him continue his spying ways, just gain some experience, and that was a good choice because he has a trade increase. Old Dirkelitis of Asinine is a superior spy now. He was able to get into Athens and get into the real nitty-gritty of the society. As you can see, interestingly enough, they have two warring factions, it looks like, right now. Oligarchists and Democrats, which is interestingly enough. Their faction leader is also very old and, well, relatively strong, but he'll die soon. And it looks like his factionaire isn't nearly as good as a commander, so perhaps it's a good time to strike when the old man kicks it. And other than that, it's a pretty quiet turn, so we'll just end the turn once more. Alright, beginning of the next turn. Looks like our Hippicoi, our cavalrymen, have been recruited, and the hoplites in Eretria have also been recruited. I am once again the richest faction, which is fantastic. Money is power, at least in this game. And financial situation. Still about 300 above what we're supposed to be, and we have about 250 for Spartans here. So, let's see here. I should do a little bit more recruiting. But right now, Ellis actually is not strong enough to support a new barracks, a Spartan-approved barracks, so maybe we'll... No, this is what I'll do. Instead of, even though it's not very accurate to recruit some rabble over here and send it over to Ellis, instead what I'll do is that we'll have my governor go out of town, recruit some mercenaries. He's going into the fields, bringing back some poor... give me 2 seconds. I'm going to recall what the slaves are called. Helots. He's going to drag some poor helots back with some cheap upkeep back to Ellis with him, forcing him into servitude. There we go. And now we have a stronger military presence in Ellis, and I can be comfortable with being as accurate as possible. Now what we'll do is we'll send this very lucky fleet over to this Ionian city, Oh, looks like we have quite a bit of activity going on over here as well. Looks like the Near East is bustling. As you can see, our docks and their docks are pretty close to one another. Like, they're trading with Argo, so there's no reason why they can't trade with us. So, I'll just go ahead and talk to them and see if we can't broker a deal. We don't want an alliance just yet. Sparta is strong and independent. So instead, we'll just ask for trade rights. And they accept the offer. In addition, I think what I'll also ask is for some map information. The basic 500. They think it's great as well. And now we have a better idea of who's owning what in, on this side of the coast. Excellent. Let's see here. For the sake of safety's sake, we'll keep the diplomat on this little protected island for now. But we'll probably be sending him back pretty soon if he makes the short but dangerous trip home. Once again, looks like the Athenians are trying to conquer Thebes, but they're still too strong for me to make a little ambush strike. I think this is going to be a little bit of an arms war between Sparta and I, and see who can be more powerful. Argos is looks like a very, very, very strong city, so I'll have to attack them later. Perhaps our next target, if we don't go for the Athenians. I'm still waiting off on waging war yet till I hear from more of the viewers. But I think this might be the next independent town, just for the sake of its weakness and its proximity to Sparta. Alright, let's just do a quick double check. All my heirs are and characters are still kicking around. Let's see if we've picked up any more. Oh, it looks like the governor has also picked up a herbalist. Increases the chance of having children. Improves the chance of casualties recovering from their wounds. That's pretty cool. Let's see here, what else? We have the exotic slave. I love that retinue. I think it's hilarious. Oh, it looks like Leonidas has become a bit of a drunkard, which is too bad. But I guess when you run an entire colony, you can have a few drinks. Oh, this is interesting. This fellow here is a free bleeder. He has a problem staunching his wounds. Hmm. Interesting. Very, very interesting. Alright, and my towns are still all constructing and recruiting, and let's see here, and my agents are doing their thing. You know what, we're going to just send my spy up here a little bit more, just to kind of check out what's going on with the Macedonians. Well, it looks like they conquered Oilenthos, okay. With a very small garrison, but it looks like a small population city anyway. Oh, it looks like it's rioting as well. The peasants are revolting. Not revolting as in they're ugly, smelly things, even though peasants probably are ugly, smelly things, but they're actually rioting. Alright, so that will do it for this turn.